In today's lecture, we will study about relations and functions of mathematics for class 12. This is given in chapter 1 of your syllabus. As you all know that the syllabus for the academic year 2021 has been reduced. The retained portions are types of relations, types of functions and binary operations. Whereas the deleted portion is composition functions and inverse of a function. The total marks for this section is 11. 1 mark question will be there. 2 mark question, 3 marks and 4 mark questions. One each in this section will be there. And there will be no 10 marks question from this section. Relations. Any set of ordered pairs x comma y within brackets is called a relation in x and y. Furthermore, the set of first components in the ordered pairs is called a domain of the relation. The set of second components in the ordered pair is called the range of relations. We will show in diagram the relationship between domain and the range. Sometimes the range is also called codomain. Definition. Relation. Let A and B be two sets. Then a relation R from set A to set B is a subset of A cross B. Types of relations. Empty relation. A relation R in a set A is called empty relation if no element of A is related to any element of A. Universal relation. A universal relation, that is, a relation R in a set A is called universal relation if each element of A is related to every element of A, that is R is equal to A cross A. Equivalence relation. A relation R in a set is said to be equivalence relation if R is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. We will define in subsequent paragraphs what is reflexive, what is symmetric and what is transitive relation. A relation R in a set A is called reflexive if A comma A belongs to R for every A belonging to A. This is, that is, if within brackets A comma A elements in belonging to relation R has every value A belonging to a set capital A, where small a is an element and capital A is a set. Symmetric relation. If within brackets A comma A belongs to R, it implies that B comma A within brackets also belongs to R for all values of A comma B, that is A comma B belonging to set A. Number 3. Transitive. A relation R in a set A is called transitive if A comma B within brackets belongs to R and B comma C belongs to R. It implies that A comma C belongs to R for all values of A comma B comma C belonging to R. Please note, the reflexive has got only one element A, whereas the symmetric relation has two components, A comma B, two elements, and the transitive relations are if has three, that is A comma B as well as C, there are three. So we will take up examples in the subsequent slides. Please note, there will be definitely a one mark question on the definitions. You have to remember all these relationships. In this slide, we have learnt about relation, we have learnt about domain, we have learnt about range, that is codomain, as well as empty relation, universal relation, equivalence relation, as well as reflexive, symmetry, and transitive relations. In subsequent slides, we will learn about the numerical problems associated with this section, relations. Define symmetric relation. Answer. A relation R in a set A is called symmetric if within brackets A comma B belongs to R implies that within brackets B comma A belonging to R for all values of A comma B belonging to A. That was the definition. Let us take up question number 2. Given A is equal to within floor brackets 4 comma 6 comma 8 comma 20 and R is given as within floor brackets and a small bracket A comma B such that A plus B equals 25, comma A comma B belong to A. Such show that the relation R is an empty set, empty relation. Answer. This is an empty set as no pair A comma B satisfies the condition A plus B equals 25. Let us take, for example, A as 4 and B as 6. Therefore, A plus B will be 10, which does not satisfy A plus B equals 25. Let us take second value, A equals 4 and B equals 8. So, A plus B will, in this case will be 12, which once again does not satisfy the given equation, A plus B is equal to 25. Let us take the third value, A equals 4 and B equals 20. A plus B in this case will be 24, and which again does not satisfy A plus B. You can also verify for A equals 6 and B equals 20, in which case it will be 26, which again does not satisfy. Therefore, if you take A as 8 and B as 20, therefore, A plus B will be 28, which does not satisfy A plus B is equal to 25. Hence, this is an empty set as no pair of A and B satisfies the condition A plus B equals 25. Question number 3. Show that the relation R in the set within floor brackets 1 comma 2 comma 3 given by R, relation R equals within floor brackets 1 comma 1 comma 2 comma 2 comma within small bracket 3 comma 3 comma within brackets 1 comma 2 comma 2 comma 3 is reflexive but neither symmetric nor transitive. Please note, again read, it has got, A has got values, elements have got 1, 2, 3, given by the relations 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 2, 2, 3, is reflexive but neither symmetric nor transitive. Let us prove it. Answer. R is reflexive. Relation is reflexive because 1, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 3 are present. Lie in R. So, the next reflexive. So, R, let us examine whether R is symmetric. So, 1, 2 is present. 2, 1 is not belonging to R. See here, 2, 1 is not present in R. Similarly, R is not transitive, in which case the condition 1, 2 belonging to R is there, 2, 3 is there, but 1, 3 is not present. Hence, it is not transitive. Question number 4. Let T be the set of all triangles in a plane with R a relation in T given by R is equal to within flower brackets T1, T2, that is triangle 1, triangle 2, such that T1 is congruent to T2. Show that R is an equivalence relation. So let us read R once again. R equals within flower brackets T1 comma T2 such that T1 is congruent to T2. Show that R is an equivalence relation. Answer. R is reflexive since every triangle is congruent to itself. This is the relation of condition of congruency. Hence, R is reflexive since every triangle is congruent to itself. That is, the condition is T1, T1, T2, T2 and T3, T3 is satisfied. Further, triangles T1 and T2 belong to R. It is given. T1, T2, R, it is given. Therefore, T1 is congruent to T2. That is a given. T1 is congruent to T2. It is also given. T2 is congruent to T1. That is also condition. It has happened. Therefore, both T1 is congruent to T2 as well as T2 is congruent to T1. Hence, both belong to R. Hence, R is symmetric. Moreover, triangles T1, T2, T3 belong to R because all lie in the same plane. Therefore, T1 is congruent to T2 and triangle T2 is congruent to T3. Hence, T1 is also congruent to T3. Therefore, T1 and T3 belong to R. R is an equivalence. That is, this is transitory. These conditions, T1 congruent to T2, T2 congruent to T3, T1 congruent to T3 are the three conditions for transitive. Hence, R is an equivalence relation when all the conditions are satisfied. Question number 5. Relation R in the set A is equal to A, 2, 3, 4, dash, dash, dash up to 13 and 14. 14 is the last digit of set A. Defined as R is equal to, within flower cut, X, Y, such that the relationship between x and y is given as 3x minus y equal to 0. Find whether R is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. So, this is a 3-mark question. And it is a very simple. Let us go and solve the problem systematically. Answer. Given A is equal to 1, 2, comma 3, comma 4 up to 14. And it is also given R within forward bracket x minus x comma y such that 3 minus y equal to 0. Let us take the relationship 3x minus y equal to 0. Or we can put 3x is equal to y. Therefore, if we put 3x, if we take x as y, it x as 1, so it will be 1 comma 3. Y will be equal to 3x. Therefore, y will be equal to 3. If x is equal to 1, y will be equal to 3. Similarly, if x is equal to 2, y is equal to 3 into 2 is 6. And if x is equal to 3, y will be equal to 9. That is, y is equal to 3x. That is equal to 3 into 3, 9. If we take x equal to 4, y will be equal to 12. Suppose we, though value of x, if we take x as 5, then y will be equal to 3x, that will be equal to 15. But 15 is not there in this set yet. Hence, the combinations are 1, 3, 2, 6, 3, 9, and 4, 12. Let us solve the problem again. Therefore, R will be equal to 1, 3, 2, 6, 3, 9, and 4, 12. You see this here. These are the, we have copied it here. Let us take question 1. Reflexive. Whether, let us examine whether it is reflexive. So, for all values of A belonging to 1, 1, R belonging to 1, 1 belongs to set A. That is 1, 3 is there. 1, 3 is there. But 1, 1 is not there. In this equation, 1, 1 is not there. Please see, in R there is no 1, 1, which is the requirement for reflexive, is not there. Hence, R is not reflexive. Number 2, let us examine whether it is symmetric. So, 1, 3 belongs to R. So, 3, 1 should, symmetric conditions require that 1, 3 should belong to R, 3, 1 should also belong to R. But in this equation, 3, 1 is not there. Hence, R is not symmetric. Let us examine for transitive. So, let us take 1, 3. 1, 3 belongs to R. So, therefore, the next value is B is 3, 9. 3, 9 is also there. So, 1, 3 is there. 3, 9 is there. Therefore, but 9, 1 is not there. You see, 9, 1 is not there in this equation R. Hence, R is not transitive. So, we have proved that R is not reflexive because 1, 1 is not there. R is not symmetric because 3, 1 is not there. And similarly, R is not transitive because 9, 1 is not there. Please note here, for reflexive, there is only one element, 1, 1, 1. For symmetric, there are two elements. In this example, 1, 3. For transitive, there are three elements, 1, 3 and 9. Hence, we have solved this problem. Let us take the next example. Question number 6. Relation R in the set A equals given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 defined as R equals A, B such that B is equal to A plus 1. Find whether R is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. This is a 3 marks question. Answer. Given A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. R is equal to A comma B such that B is equal to A plus 1. Therefore, R is A plus 1. That is, if you take A, R will be 1 plus 2. That is, B is equal to A plus 1. If A is 1, B is equal to 2. If A is 2, B is equal to 2 plus 1. That is 3 in this equation. Similarly, if A is equal to 3, B will be equal to 3 plus 1, 4. Similarly, if you take A as 4, B will be 5. And lastly, if A is 5, B will be equal to 6. So we have written the relationship R equals 1 comma 2, 2 comma 3, 3 comma 4, 4 comma 5 and 5 comma 6. Let us examine for reflexive. For all values of A belonging to 1 comma 1 belong to R, but 1 comma 1 does not belong to R. So in this relation, you see 1 comma 1 is not there. It starts with 1 comma 2. So 1 comma 1 is not there. Hence R is not reflexive. Now for the relationship 1 comma 2, let us start with 1 comma 2. 1 comma 2 belongs to R. But 2 comma 1 is not there here. So for symmetric, both 1 comma 2 should belong to R and 2 comma 1 should also belong to R. But 2 comma 1 is not belonging to R. Hence, R is not symmetric. See, this black relationship is the requirement of symmetric. But this is actual. The blue colored is actual. Hence, it is not symmetric. Number 3, transitive. Now, we have to start with 1 comma 2 belonging to R. Then 2 comma 3 belonging to R. Then 3 comma 1, 1 comma 3 should also be there to satisfy transitive relation and relation. 1 comma 3 should also be there. But if you see here in this equation, there is no 1 comma 3. That is, 1 comma 3 is not belonging to R. Hence, R is not transitive. So the question, the relationship in question number 6 is neither reflexive, nor symmetric, nor transitive. Question number 7. Show that the relations R in set A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 given as R equals A comma B such that this vertical line says such that modulus of A minus B is even is an equivalence relationship. That means R equals A comma B such that mod A minus B is even should be examined as to prove equivalence relation. Let us solve it. A equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 given. R is given A comma B such that A minus absolute A minus B is even. So number 1, we know that A minus A is even. That is, A minus A equals 0, which is even. 0 is even. Therefore, A comma A belongs to R. So R is reflexive. It is proved it is reflexive. A comma A, 1 minus 1 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0, 3 minus 3 is 0, 4 minus 4 is 0, 5 minus 5 is 0. Hence, for all values of A, R is reflexive. The next relation is symmetric relation. It is given A comma B belongs to R. A comma B belongs to R, and we have to prove B comma A also belongs to R. So modulus of A minus B is E1. So let us take given minus of B minus A is also E1. That is, let us take modulus of 4. E1 means 2, 4, 2 and 4. So 2 minus 2 here is 0, that is E1. So we have proved. So therefore minus of 2 minus 2 is 0, minus 0, which is modulus is also 0. Here similarly, modulus of 4 is also 0. That is 4 minus 4 equals 0, E1. Hence modulus of 4 is also E1. Hence we have proved R is symmetric. Transitive. The condition, the requirement of transitive is A comma B should belong to R, B comma C should belong to R, and A comma C should also belong to R. Let us examine. A mod A minus B is E1, mod B minus C is also E1. Sum of two even quantities is E1. Two even, say for example, 2 plus 4 is 6. 6, 4 plus 6 is 10, which both are even. That is, sum of two even quantities is even. Therefore, let us examine A minus B plus B minus C is even. Therefore, A minus C is even. Hence, A comma B belongs to R, B comma C belongs to R, and A comma C also belongs to R. Hence, R is transitive. So, since all the three relations are reflexive, symmetric, and transitive are proved, hence R is an equivalence relations. Alternate method. We can also prove this in alternate by giving example. R is given by the relations 1 comma 1, 1 comma 3, 1 comma 5, 2 comma 2, 2 comma 4, 3 comma 1, 3 comma 3, 3 comma 5, 4 comma 2, 4 comma 4, 5 comma 1, 5 comma 3, 5 comma 4 and 5 comma 5. That is modulus A minus B. That is 1. If you take modulus, if you calculate the value mod A, A is 1 minus B is 2. Minus 2 is minus 1. So therefore it is 1 comma 1. 1 comma 3. If you take the value of 2 and substitute B as 3 in this equation, you will get this relationship. Therefore, 1 comma 1 belongs to R, 2 comma 2 belongs to R, 3 comma 3 belongs to R, 4 comma 4 belongs to R, 5 comma 5 belongs to R. Hence, R is reflexive. The next relation is for symmetry. 1 comma 3 is there and 3 comma 1 is also there. 1 comma 5 is there. 5 comma 1 is also there, belonging to R. Therefore, 3 comma 5 belongs to R. 5 comma 3 from this equation belongs to R. Hence, R is symmetric. Then the third, that is for transitive, 1 comma 3 should be there and 3 comma 5 should be there. 3 comma 5 is also there, belonging to R. Therefore, 1 comma 5 should also belong to R. Where is 1 comma 5 here? 1 comma 5 is here. All the three, 1 comma 3 belong to R, 3 comma 5 belong to R, 1 comma 5 belong to R. Hence it is transitive. Since all are the three relations, reflexive, symmetric and transitive, it is equivalence relations. This is an alternate method. Either you can follow this or that. function. Definition of a function. A function is a relation between a set of inputs and a set of permissible outputs with the property that each input is related to exactly one output. In its simplest terms, a function is a relation between inputs and permissible outputs. Please see the figure. There are two sets. The first set is an input set. That is, it is also called as a domain. Input is domain. And the second set containing elements 9 and 5 is a range. That is, it is also called codomain in some of the books. So, by definition, a function is a relation between input and output. And the property should be such that each input is related to exactly one output. So here you see 1 to 1 is not there. Input 2, 4, there are 3 elements in the first set A, that is input set, and 2 elements N. There is no exact 1 to 1 relation in function. Whereas in the second example, the domain has 3 elements, 2, 4 and 11. And the codomain has 3 elements, 9, 6 and 5. The arrows linking input to output are also shown. So 2 to 9, it is given, 4 to 6 and 11 to 5. So domain and codomain are interrelated such that each input is related to exactly one output. See example 2. Here, the domain is represented as x1 and codomain as x2. There are 4 elements in input domain x1, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. Whereas, in output domain or range, in output range or codomain, there are 6 elements A, B, C, D, E, and F. The relation between input and output is also shown by the arrow, blue colored arrows. So 1 is related to A, 2 is related to B, 3 is related to D, and 4 is related to C. That is the link relationship. And hence the 4 inputs are related to 4 outputs separately, whereas outputs E and F do not have any link with the input. A function is a relation for which each value from the set of the first component here is 2, 4, 11 of the ordered pair is associated with exactly one value. So 2 is related to 9, 4 to 6 and 11 to 5 from the set of second component. This is the set of second components of the ordered pair. Types of functions. 1-1, 1-1 or injective, it is also called injective, is by definition a function f from x to y is defined to be 1-1 or injective if images of the distinct elements of the x under f are distinct. That is, for every value a and b in x is related as f of a is equal to f of b, which implies that a is equal to b. Otherwise, it is called minimum. So, in this example, 1-1 or 1-1 injective, one element is related to b. Suppose it is a and b. a b in a domain x is related to a b in b, that such that a is equal to b. So f of x should be easy, f of a should be f of b, implies that a is equal to b. This is 1-1. This is here also, you see one element, images of one distinct elements of x1 are distinct for every x2. Therefore, f of a is equal to f of b implies that a is equal to b. So this is, these two examples are for 1-1 function. Please see this another example here in given to on their extreme right hand side. There are four elements 1, 2, 3, 4. There are six elements in the output x2, but if you see, the output element b has two images 1 and 2. So that is 1 and 2 are having the same connected to b, that is 1 and 2. Hence this is not a 1-to-1. This example 2 is not 1-to-1 because the inputs 1 and 2 are having the same output b. That is why this is not 1-to-1. On to function, or this is also called subsurjective. A function f from x to y is said to be onto if every element of y is the image of some element of x under f. That is, for every y in y, there exists an element x in x such that f of x is equal to y. Let us see in the diagram. Please see the diagram. There is an input colored pink set A, B, D, E. There are four elements. And in the output box, that is in the range or codomain, there are 3, 1, 9 and 8. So A is related to 1, B is associated with 9, D is also associated with 9, E is related to 8, is associated with 8. So every element, say, suppose this is X, pink color box is X, and blue colored is Y. So every Y is related to X. Hence, by definition, see, 1 is associated, has an image A, 9 has an image B and D, and 8 has image E. So by definition, onto is, this is onto function, a function F, X to Y, this is X to Y, is said to be onto if every element of Y, this is Y, every element of Y is the image of some element X. So this is Y is the image of X under F. That is under F. For every Y in Y, there exists an X in X. This is such that X is equal to Y. This is called onto function. Please see, this figure also has four inputs. That is X1. That every element in X2 is related to, every element in X is related to element in X1. X2 is related to X1. Hence, this is also an example of onto. Bijective function. A function F such that X2Y is said to be 1-1 and onto are bijective if f is both 1 and onto. That means if a function satisfies the type of function 1-1 and onto, that is if it is 1-1 as well as onto, then it is a bijective function. See, let us see the example. Here you see, this is, there are six elements in the input A. This is A, set A has elements A, B, C, D, E, F. And the set B has six elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So A is associated to 2, B is associated to 4, D is associated to 5, E is associated to 6, and F is associated to 3. That means B is a function. All elements of A are associated with elements of output set B. Hence, 1-1 is satisfied. Now, let us examine for 1 to on to. So we have to start with the output here, that is Y. 1 has an image in A, that is C. 2 has an image in A, that is A. 3 has an image in A, that is F. 4 has an image in A, that is B. 4 is to B. 5 has an image in A, that is D. 6 has an image in E. Therefore, all the 6 elements of set A are associated with output in set B, that is 1, 1. And similarly, onto is also satisfied. That is, elements of group B have image in A. Question number 1. Prove that function F from R to R given by fx is equal to 2x is 1, 1 and on 2. That is, fx1 is equal to fx2. To prove 1 on 1, we have one condition we have to prove. F of x1 is equal to f of x2. Here, f of x is given as f of x is equal to 2x. Therefore, 2x1 is equal to 2x2. That is, x1 is equal to x2. Therefore, f is 1 on 1. 1, 1. Also, given any real number y in R, there exist y by 2 in such a way that f of y by 2 is equal to y. Hence, f is onto. That means you put, given as, put y is equal to 2x or x is equal to y by 2 and x is equal to y by 2. Hence, for every relations R, in R, there is a value. Hence, f is onto. Question number 2. Let A is equal to 1, 2, 3 and B is equal to 4, 5, 6, 7. Let F is equal to within floral brackets 1, 4, 2, 5 and 3, 6 be function from A to B. Show that F is not on 2. We have to prove that F is not on 2. Therefore, 7 belongs to B, has no pre-image. See here, A is 1, 2, 3. And if 1, 4 is there, 2, 5 is there, 3, 6 is there. But 7 is free. Hence, this is F is, this function is not onto function. Question number 3. If F from R to R is defined as f of x is equal to 4x minus 1 for all values of x belonging to R, prove that f is 1 to 1. 1, 1. Therefore, for any two elements, x1 and x2 belonging to R, fx1 for fx1 is equal to fx2. That is, for function 1, 1, we have to prove fx1 is equal to fx2. Therefore, we have 4x1 minus 1. This is the relationship. Put x is equal to x1. We should also have 4x2 minus 1 for meeting the condition for the relation fx1 is equal to fx2. So therefore, 1, 1 gets cancelled, 4, 4 gets cancelled. Therefore, x1 is equal to x2. So when x1 is equal to x2, it is an 1, 1. Hence, f is 1, 1. Next example. Question number 4. Show that the function f from n to n given by f1 is equal to f2 is equal to 1 and fx is equal to x minus 1 for every x greater than 2 is on 2 but not 1 on 1. That is, we have to prove fx is equal to x minus 1 is on 2 but not 1 1. Let us do it. Answer. F is not 1 1 as f1 and f2 is equal to 1. So 1 has got both f1 as well as s2. So for 1 1 there should not be two values in group in codomain. This 1 is codomain, 1 and 2 are domain and 1 is codomain. So one codomain has two functions, one f1 and f2. Hence, it is not 1, 1. One condition is not 1, 1 is proved. Next one. Now, given y is equal to x minus 1, that is f of x is equal to x minus 1 or y is equal to x minus 1 or x rearranging, x is equal to shifting y here, x is equal to y plus 1. But if f is on 2 as given, y belongs to n, but y is not equal to 1. Therefore, we can choose x as y plus 1 such that f of y plus 1 is equal to y plus 1 minus 1, that is x minus 1. If you put x as y plus 1 here, y plus 1, y, therefore y, f of y plus 1 is equal to y. Also for 1 belonging to n, that is natural number, we have f of 1 is equal to 1. Thus, it is on 2. Question number 5. Show that the function f from R to R defined as fx is equal to x square is neither 1, 1 nor on 2. We have to prove two conditions. 1, 1 on and on 2. Answer. F of minus 1 equals F1 is not 1, 1. Also, the element for negative values, F of minus 1 equals 1, F of 1 minus 1, F of minus 1 equals 1 equals F of 1 is not 1, 1. So, the square, if you take square, f of 1 is minus 1 is whole square is 1. And that is also equal to f of 1. So, there are two values, f of 1 equals 1 and f of minus 1 also equal 1. Hence, it is not 1, 1. Also, the element minus 2 in the codomain R is not image of any element x in the domain R. Therefore, it is not on 2. If you take minus 2, x as a fact minus 2, that will be is equal to plus or minus 2 square. So, co is not an image of any element. Minus 2 is not an element in the domain R. Therefore, it is f is not on 2. Question number 6. Show that the function f r suffix star from r suffix stars to r suffix stars defined by fx is equal to 1 by x is 1 1 and on 2 where r star is the set of all non-zero. See, this is a special real numbers. R generally is a set of real numbers, but R star is non-zero, that is, it starts with, there is no zero in this number. is the result true if the domain R star is replaced by N, that is N is natural number, R is the real set of real number with codomain being same R star? The answer, F, it is F is from R star to R star. So F of X will be equal to 1 by X. It is given. F of X is given as F of X is equal to 1 by N. We are required to prove Fx1 is equal to Fx2. If we prove Fx1 is equal to Fx2, that is X1 is equal to X2, then it is 1-1 relation. So f of x1 given as 1 over x1, that is also equal to 1 over x2. Therefore, if we reverse it, x1 is equal to x2. Therefore, f is 1, 1. This is proved. Part 1 part is proved for R. Now, y is equal to, we have to substitute in this equation, y is equal to 1 by x, or x is equal to 1 by a, y belonging to R star. So y is not 0 because R star is a non-zero. So y, if you put 0, y equals 0, it is a non-existing. It becomes infinity. It does not belong to R. But y is not 0. Therefore, f of x is equal to 1 over y. Therefore, that is equal to y. Therefore, f of x is y. Therefore, f is an onto. Now, part B, that is, if the domain Rn is replaced by n, that is, n to f is starting from n to R star. Therefore, we know f of x, it is given, is equal to 1 over x. Therefore, f of x1 is equal to 1 over x1, that is also equal to 1 over x2. And therefore, x1 is equal to x2. Therefore, f is 1, 1. Now, we will put y is equal to 1 over x, or x is equal to 1 over y. If we take minus 2 belonging to R star, that is, in R star, the real numbers are, it has got both positive and negative. So, minus 2 belongs to R and y is not 0. Therefore, there does not exist because n is the positive, n group fx is in positive only. Therefore, for minus 2, there is no exist image in set n. Hence, f is not an onto function because there is no image. Let us see this diagram. You see, n in this case, n has got only positive numbers, non-zero. It starts with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. Whereas R has got minus 3.5, minus 3, minus 2, 0, 1, all both positive and negative number. For example, you take minus 2. Minus 2 does not have any relation. Minus 2 does not belong any image in N. Therefore, there does not exist a pre-image in set N. This is set N. This blue colored set is a N and R. R is a function of N. That is, from N to R is the relationship. This you see here, when F is equal to N to, from N to R, from N to R, 1 over X1, and we have calculated. Hence, therefore, F is not an onto function. Let us take the next example. Question number 7. Check the injectivity and surjectivity of the following. That is, on and onto functions of the following given functions. So let us take first case, 7-1. Function f from n to n given by fx is equal to x square. That is, the domain is fx and this one is codomain is x square. N is a natural number. See, n is a natural number, non-zero, 1 to 6 and positive numbers. Therefore, n from n to n given by fx is equal to x square. Therefore, fx is equal to x square and fx1 is equal to fx2. Therefore, x1 square is equal to x2 square. Therefore, plus or minus x1 equals plus or minus x2. Therefore, for all positive values of x1 in n, there are positive values of n in the group 2. N. So, f is 1 to 1. Fx is equal to x square. So, now to prove onto function, we have to put fx is equal to x square given and y as x square. That is, x is equal to square root of y. Square root, when square root of any number is taken, it does not belong to a natural number. You see, there is no square root of numbers here. Certain number, there is no square root. Hence, it does not belong to n. Hence, fx is not onto. Hence, f is not onto. Question number 7. Part 2. F from z to z. Z is an integer. Integer means it will have both values, plus as well as minus, given by the relation fx is equal to x square, where z is an integer. So from z to z, given by fx is equal to x square, see there are two relationships. This is one domain and codomain. So there are numbers, group, minuses, so all numbers, it has got all values, minus 3, minus 4, 2, all negative and positive. Similarly, it has got both negative and positive. Therefore, fx1 is equal to fx2, it is given x1 square is equal to x2 square, plus or minus x1, plus or minus x2. Therefore, x1 is not equal to minus x1, x2. Therefore, it has got different value and f is not 1 to 1. Again, to prove onto function, fx is equal to x square, y is equal to x square, that is x is equal to square root 2, which does not belong to z. Hence, f is not onto for z, for all values of z. Question number 7.3. F, that is f is equal to from R to R given by fx is equal to x square. That is R has all positive and negative numbers as shown in this diagram. Therefore, f from R to R is given by the relation fx is equal to x square. Fx is equal to x square, fx1 is equal to fx2. And x1 square is equal to x2 square, plus or minus x1 is equal to plus or minus x2. Therefore, if you take x1 as a positive and x2 as negative, then x1 is not equal to minus x2. Therefore, f is not 1, 1. Next, to prove onto fx is equal to x square, y is equal to x square. That is, x is equal to square of root of y, which does not belong to R. Hence, f is not onto. Question number 7, part 4. F from n to n given by fx is equal to x cube. Answer, n to n, that is natural number to natural number, given by fx is equal to x cube. So fx is equal to x cube, fx1 is equal to fx2, x1 cube is equal to x2 cube. Therefore, x1 is equal to x2. X1 is equal to x2, f is 1, 1. Fx is equal to x cube. That is x cube, y is equal to x cube. You have to put y here as x cube. Or find the value, that is x is equal to cube root of y. This is given cube root of y. So cube root does not belong to n. N is a natural number and whole number 1, 2, 3. Whereas if you take cube root, you will get fractions also. Hence, cube root of y does not belong to n. Therefore, f is not onto function. So in this case, fx is equal to x cubed is f is 1, 1 but not onto. Question number 8. Prove that the greatest integer, that is less than or equal to function f from R to R given by fx is equal to greatest function x is neither 1 nor onto, where x within brackets, big bracket, denotes the greatest integer, that is less than or equal to x. Answer. F of x is equal to within big bracket x. Therefore, f of minus 1 is equal to minus of f of 1. That is greatest number is 1 and that is equal to 1. Let us examine the conditions of less than or equal to function, that is greatest integer. For all positive values, the greatest integer is to be taken the whole number. That is, for positive value like f of 1 plus 1 within big bracket, 1.1 within big bracket is equal to 1. This is the relationship of greatest integer, that is less than or equal to. But for negative numbers, that is f of minus of 1.1, that is equal to minus 2. That is the next highest digit, because minus 2 is lower than minus 1.1. Hence, minus 2 is taken. Whereas for positive values, 1.1, the highest digit is less than or equal to 1 is taken as 1. The whole number is 1. Similarly, for other values like minus 2.5 and 1.5, the relations are shown. For minus 2.5, it is minus 3, and for plus 1.5, it is 1. This is the greatest integer function. So consider an example f of 2. F of 2 is equal to f of 2.5, that is equal to 2. So f is not 1 to 1. For all values like f of 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.5, the f of 2 is taken. So equals to the value is 2. So there is f is not 1 on 1. Then consider another example f of 2.5. belonging to R. F of 2.5 also belongs to R. There does not exist a pre-image inset R. Hence, F is not onto. So, there is no image for F of 2.5 in R. Question number 9. Show the modulus function F from R to R given by Fx is equal to mod x is neither 1 nor onto, where mod x is x, and if x is positive or 0, and mod x is minus x if x is negative. So we will define modulus function as per the given condition. It is given f of x is equal to mod x, that is equal to f of x is equal to minus x. You see here it is minus x for x negative. Negative means less than 0. For f of x is x, it is f of mod x is x if x is positive. For x is positive or 0. That is, for x greater than or equal to 0, fx is x, it is given. Therefore, f of 1 is equal to 1, f of minus 1 is also equal to 1, f of 2.5, mod 2.5 is 2.5. So therefore, see, f of minus 1 is equal to 1. That this is, you see, for negative, f of minus 1 is also equal to 1. That is, f of minus 1 is minus 1. F of 1 is 1. And f of minus 1 is minus 1. Therefore, f of minus 2.5 is mod 2.5. That is equal to, mod 2.5 is equal to 2.5. That is, f of minus 2.5 is also equal to 2.5. Therefore, f is not 1 to 1. That is, for minus 2.5, it is 2.5. Now, we will take for onto function. Minus 3. Consider the value minus 3 belonging to R. There does not exist the pre-image in set R. Therefore, f is not onto function. Next example. Question number 10. Show that the signum function f from R to R given by fx is neither 1 to 1 1 or onto function. Therefore, the signum function is defined as f of x is equal to 1 plus 1 for all positive values x greater than 0. It is 0 for x is equal to 0 and minus 1 if x is less than 0. This is a signum function. Example, f of 1 is equal to f of 2 is equal to 1 because f of x is equal to 1 for all values of x greater than 0. Therefore, for all negative values x than less 0, it is equal to minus 1. Minus 3.5 also 1, minus 2 also minus 1, like that. It is minus 1 for all values of x. For all negative values of x. Therefore, f is not 1 to 1. So, next is, let us take another example, 2 belonging to R. Let us consider another number, 2 belonging to R. Therefore, there does not exist a pre-image in set R. So, if there is a number 2 belonging to R, there is no image for this. Hence, f is not onto function. It is proved. Question number 11. Let A is equal to 1, 2, 3. B is equal to 4, 5, 6, 7. And let f is equal to 1, 4, 2, 5 and 3, 6. Be a function from A to B. Show that f is 1 to 1. So, it is given A is equal to 1, 2, 3. B is 4, 5, 6. You see, this is 4, 5, 6. It is given. Therefore, f is 1, 4. 1, 2, 4. Here, f is 1, 2, 4. Then 2 to 5, you see here 2 to 5 and 3 to 6. Therefore, 3 to 6. All these three elements are having three relations in B, group B. Whereas for F for 7, F of 1 is equal to 4, F of 2 is 5 and F of 3 is 6. Therefore, F is 1 to 1. Therefore, 1 to 1. It is proved. So, onto is not asked. It is not onto because 7 does not have any relation with any image in this group A. Question number 12. In each of the following cases, state whether the function is 1, 1, onto or bijective. Justify your answer. So, case number 1. F is from R to R defined by fx is equal to 3 minus 4x. Answer. For any two elements x1, x2 belonging to R such that fx1 is equal to function x2. We have 3 minus 4x1, that is given, 3 minus 4x. So put x is equal to x1, we get 3 minus 4x1. Similarly, that on the right hand side, we get 3 minus 4x2. Therefore, comparing 4x1 is equal to 4x2 or x1 is equal to x2. Therefore, f is 1, 1. Now again, to find onto, we know fx is equal to 3 minus 4x. So that fx is equal to y is equal to 3 minus 4x. Therefore, simplifying, we get value of x here, simplifying, x is equal to y minus of y minus y minus 3 divided by 4, or again simplifying, 3 minus y by 4, which again as per the statement belongs to R. Therefore, fx is equal to, you put the value of y as 3 minus 4x. Therefore, fx is equal to 3 minus 4 into x is 3 minus y by 4. That's the simplifying, we get fx is equal to y. Therefore, f is onto function. Case number 2. F is from R to R defined by fx is equal to 1 plus x square, where R is a real number. Answer: for any two elements x1, x2 belonging to R, such that fx1 is equal to fx2, we have given function 1 plus x1 square is equal to 1 plus x2 square. Therefore, x1 square is equal to x2 square. R plus or minus x1 is not equal to plus or minus x2, because if x on the left hand side x1 is plus x1, right hand side can be minus of x2. Therefore, plus x1 is not equal to minus x2, or in other way, minus x1 is equal to plus x2, it can be. So f1 is not 1, 1. Fx is equal to 1 plus x square. Therefore, y is equal to, put y is equal to 1 plus x square. Therefore, square root of y minus 1 is not equal to r. Therefore, let us consider y is equal to 0. When y is equal to 0, square root of minus I, that is not belonging to r. Therefore, f is not onto. Question number 13. Let A and B be sets. Show that if F is from A cross B to B cross A, such that F of AB is equal to BA is objective function. We know given F is from A cross B, that is equal to B cross A. It is given f of AB is equal to f of BA. That, consider the example here, the function fx, x1 is equal to 1, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, 6, 1, 4 and all that for different values of x. Therefore, that can be written as 4, 1, 5, 1, like that, substituting various values of x. Therefore, f for f is equal to 1 comma 4, there is correspondingly 4 comma 1 cross product. Therefore, fx1 is equal to fx2. Therefore, x1 is equal to x2. Hence, f is 1, 1. Again, taking f of AB is equal to f of BA. So, B comma A belongs to B cross A. Therefore, A comma B belongs to A cross B. And therefore, F is onto. Hence, F is bijective. Question number 14. Let F from n to n be defined by fn, that is within flower brackets n plus 1 divided by 2 if n is odd, and n by 2 if n is even for all values of a n belonging to capital N. State whether the function f is bijective. Justify your answer. When n is odd, that is fn is equal to n plus 1 by 2. Therefore, f of 1 is equal to 1. And f of 3 is equal to 1. That is for odd values. Odd values means n is equal to 1 and n is equal to 3. If n is equal to 1, it is 1. F n is equal to 1. And if n is equal to 2, if n is equal to 3, it will be 3 plus 1 for odd values. 3 plus 1, 4 by 2 is 2. Therefore, n plus 1 divided by 2, that is 2r minus 1, that is equal to n belonging to n. Therefore, fn will be is equal to 2 of 2r minus 1 plus 1 divided by 2, that is equal to r. Therefore, f is an onto function. Therefore, f is not 1 to 1. And fn is an onto function for odd values. Now, case 2. When n is even, we know fn is equal to n by 2. Therefore, f of 2 is equal to 2 by 2, that is equal to 1. Therefore, f of 4 is equal to 4 by 2, that is equal to 1. Therefore, f is not 1, 1. R is equal to n by 2, that is equal to 2r, that is n by 2, 2r is equal to n. Therefore, fn is equal to 2, that is equal to r, that is simplifying r, which belongs to n. Therefore, f is an onto function. Next question. Next case. Question number 15. Let A is equal to R minus within flower bracket 3 and B is equal to R minus within flower bracket 1. Consider the function from A to B defined by fx is equal to x minus 2 divided by x minus 3. Is f 1 1 and onto? Justify your answer. Answer: f of x1 is equal to f of x2. Therefore, we have to substitute the value of x1 and x2 in the respective equation. The given equation is x minus 2 divided by x minus 3. Therefore, it becomes, left hand side becomes x1 minus 2 divided by x1 minus 3. On the right hand side, we get x2 minus 2 divided by x2 minus 3. Therefore, simplifying, multiplying, cross multiplying in simplifying, we get minus of 3x1 minus 2x2 is equal to minus 2x1 minus 3x2. Therefore, it becomes x1 is equal to x2. Therefore, it becomes x1 is equal to x2. Therefore, f is 1, 1. Again, substituting the given equation, fx is equal to x minus 2 divided by x minus x3 as y, we get y is equal to x minus 2 divided by x minus 3. That is equal to xy minus 3y cross multiplying. That is equal to x minus 2. And simplifying, we get x into y minus 1 is equal to 3y minus 2. Again, therefore, x is equal to 3y minus 2 divided by y minus 1. And we get fx is equal to substituting the value of y as x minus 2 divided by x minus 3 in the given equation. In the equation, we get in this equation 3 into y minus 2 divided by y minus 3 minus 2 divided by y minus 2 divided by y minus 3. We get f of x as y. Therefore, f is an onto function. Now, having studied functions, we will go to the next section, that is binary operations. Let us start with the definitions of binary operations. A binary operation, star or asterisk on the set A is function star is equal to A cross A to A. We denote star as A comma B by A star B. Therefore, a binary operation, star is defined on set A, set as a function from A cross A to A. Star AB is denoted by A star B. This is the binary, this is the symbol or notion of A cross B of a binary operations. Binary operations has got four properties. One is commutative. A binary operation star is defined as a set A is set to B. That is commutative means A star B is equal to B star A. Associative. A binary operation star is defined on set A is called associative if A cross within brackets B cross C is equal to A cross B close the bracket cross into star B. I will repeat, A star B star C is equal to A star B within brackets star C. That is, the brackets are interchanging. A, there are three elements for associative, and for commutative it is two elements A and B, and for associative it is A B C and brackets. Please note it very carefully. A star B cross C is equal to A cross B cross C. Identity. If star is binary operation on A, then element E in A is said to be identity. That if A star E equals E star A for every A in A, identity element is unique. Then inverse. If star is binary operation on set A, then an element B is said to be inverse of A belonging to A if A star B is equal to B star A is equal to E. Inverse of an element if it exists in is unique. Question number 1. Show that addition plus subtraction minus multiplication into our binary operations on R, but division is not a binary operation on R. Further show that division is a binary operation on R suffix star of non-zero real number. That is, R suffix star is a non-zero real number. Answer plus. Plus is from R cross R to R is given by A comma B, that is equal to A plus B. This is the A because it is addition, so here it is A plus B. Therefore, minus is R cross R to R is given by A comma B and A minus B. Therefore, into is R cross R to R is given by A comma B, that is belonging to AB. Since plus minus and into are functions, plus minus and into are functions, they are binary operations on R. But division R cross R to R is given by within brackets A comma B to A by B. This is A comma B. Division is written as A by B, is not a function. We have proved it in the previous section and hence not a binary operation. As for B and B is equal to 0, A by B is not defined. These are the from basic knowledge of multiplication, division, addition and subtraction. However, a special case, division is equal to R suffix star cross R suffix stars to R star is given by A comma B to A by B, that is A by B is a function, hence a binary operation on R. So division on R star cross R star to R star is a binary operation. Next question, show that subtraction and division are not, subtraction and binary are not binary operations on n. Answer, we know minus negative sign is n on n. The previously it was r, in this case it is n. Therefore n cross n to n is given by a comma b, that is a minus b. So not a binary operation. As the image of 3 comma 5 example, for example under minus is 3 minus 5 equals minus 2, right, which is not belonging to n. Therefore if minus, this is subtraction, it is not belonging to n. Minus 2 is not belonging to n, hence it is not a binary operation. Similarly division n cross n to n given by a by b is not a binary operation, as the image of 3 by 5 is 3 divided by 5, which is not belonging to n, because it becomes a fraction, denominator is higher than the numerator, hence it is not belonging to n, is not a binary operation. Question number 3, show that star from R to R to R is given by a plus 4b square is a binary operation. Here the equation is given, R cross R is given, AB is given as a plus 4b square. Let us solve it. Answer, since star carries each pair a comma b to unique element, a plus 4b square in R, binary is a type of equation here, binary operations on R. Question number 4, let P be the set of all subsets of a given set X. Show union P cross P to P is given by A comma B to A union B, and intersection P cross P to P given by AB to A intersection B are binary operations on set. This is to prove binary operations of sets A union B and A intersection B. From our knowledge of previous class, we know that union operation U carries each pair A comma B in P cross P to unique element A union B in P, comma, union is a binary operation on P. Similarly, the intersection operation carries a pair A cross A comma B in P, and P is a unique element. Hence, A intersection B in A binary operations. Question number 5. Show that V R cross R to R given by AB, maximum value AB, and the minimum R cross R is given by AB comma minimum. I will read question number 5 again. Show that the logical R, this red V is logical R. From R cross R to R given by the representation max A comma B, and the logical AND, this is the logical AND representation, symbol of logical AND, from R cross R to R given by A comma B to minimum A comma B are binary operations. Here it is explained. Note, V is logical R and inverted V is logical AND operations. Answer. Since V carries each pair A, comma B in R to R to a unique element, namely maximum A and B lying in R, and V is a binary operation. Using similar argument, one can say that the logical AND is also a binary operation. Here, nutshell, union and intersection are binary operation of a set or a binary operation. Similarly, logical OR and logical AND are also binary operations. Let us take the next question. Example, V is, you take example 4 comma 7 is equal to 7. That is, here the maximum value is 7. Similarly, for min minimum 4 comma minus 7, it is 4. So the maximum value is taken here. That is the logical value. Similarly, for AND operation, logical AND operation, we have to take the lower value. 4 comma 7 is equal to 4. See, and 4 comma minus 7 is minus 7. These are the binary operations. Question number 6. Define a binary operation on set. That is a one mark question. Let S be a non-empty set. The function star from S cross S to S, which associates each ordered pair A comma B of the elements of S. That is, S is a non-empty set to a unique element S denoted by A star B is called a binary operation or a binary composition on S. This definition we have also seen previously. You have to remember, write and practice it. There will be definitely a one mark question on the definitions. Question number 7. Determine whether or not each of the definition defined below is binary operation. Justify. This is also one mark question. A. On z plus, that is the positive integer defined by A star B is equal to absolute A minus B. So therefore, that is the part 2 is on z plus, that is positive integer defined by A star B is equal to A. Answer. We have for A comma B belonging to z plus, A star B is equal to absolute A minus B. That is all we know. A minus B is, the mod of A minus B is always positive. Hence, for all values of A, A comma B belonging to Z plus, A star B is equal to absolute A minus B is a positive integer. Hence, star is a binary operation on Z plus. Clearly, A star B is also equal to A. This is the second part. This is A cross B is equal to A. It is given. So A belongs to Z plus for all values of A comma B belonging to Z plus. And thus, star is a binary operation on Z plus. Next question. Commutative operation. A binary operation on star on set X is called commutative if A star B equals B star A for every A comma B belonging to X. Question number 8. Show that positive, that is addition, from R cross R to R and multiplication from R cross R to R are commutative binary operations. That is, addition and multiplication are binary operation, and subtraction, that is minus, R from R cross R to R, and division, and R suffix star cross R suffix star to R star are not commutative. This we have to prove it. Since A plus B is equal to B plus A and A cross B is equal to B cross A for all values of A comma B belonging to R, positive and multiplication are commutative binary operations. However, negative is not a commutative since 3 minus 4 is not equal to 4 minus 3. Similarly, 3 divided by 4 is not equal to 4 by 3, which shows that division is not commutative. Subtraction is also not commutative. Question number 9. Show that star from R cross R to R defined by A star B is equal to A plus 2B is not commutative. This we have to prove it. Therefore, 3. Let us take example A as 3 and B as 4. So, 3 star 4 is equal to, that is, if you put A plus B, A as 3 plus 2 into 4, 8 equals to 11. Similarly, taking reverse, B cross A, 4 star 3, that is equal to 4 plus 2 into 3, 6, that is equal to 10. So both are not same, showing that operation star is not commutative on A plus 2B. Next question, definition. A binary operation star from A cross A to A is said to be associative. That is associative A cross B within bracket, A star B within bracket, star C equals A star within brackets B star C. That is the brackets are interchanged. Here the bracket is A star B and in the right hand side it is B star C for all values of A, B and C belong to A. Question number 10. Show that addition and multiplication are associative binary operations on R. But subtraction is not associative on R. Division is also not associative. Let us prove it. Addition and multiplication are associative because A plus B within brackets plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. So you can see both the left hand side and right hand side are same. Similarly, for multiplication, A cross B within brackets into cross C is equal to A into A cross B cross C within brackets for all values of A, B, C belonging to R. However, subtraction and division are not associative. Let us take example. A as 8 and B as 5. So, 8 minus 5 minus 3 and value of C is 3 is not equal to 8 minus of within bracket 5 minus 3. 5 minus 3 is 2. 2 by 8 minus 2 is 6. Whereas left hand side is 0. So, they are not equal. Similarly, 8 divided by 5 divided by 3 is not equal to 8 divided by 5 divided by 3. This you can verify yourself. Question number 11. Show that star from R cross R to R given by A star B to A such that A plus B to B is not associative. So this is not associative. So the operation is not associative. You assign the value A as 8, B as 5 and C as 3. Some arbitrary values, positive. Therefore 8 plus 10, A plus 5, A plus 2B is 8 plus 2 into 5 is 10 plus 3. That is 18 plus 3 is left hand side is 21. Right hand side is 8 plus 10 plus 6. That is 24. Therefore, left hand side is not equal to right hand side. While now the other operation is 8 into, that is associative, 8 into 5 plus 3, 8 plus 5 into 3, 5 plus 3 is a plus 2b is a plus 2b is 8, a is 8 plus 2b, 5 plus 3 is equal to 8 plus 3, that is equal to 8 plus 22, that is equal to 30. Therefore, they are not equal, they are not associative. Definition 3. Given a binary operation star is equal to A star A, from A star A to A cross A to A, an element E belonging to A, if it exists, is called identity. For the operation star, if A star E is equal to A and E star A, that is A star E is equal to E star A, that is equal to A, for all values of A belonging to A, that is identity. Show that the 0 is the identity for addition on R and 1 is the identity for multiplication. But there is no identity element for operations subtraction from R cross R to R and division R star R suffix star cross R suffix star to R suffix stars. Here we have to show that is A plus 0 is equal to A. Similarly, A into 1 is 1. A into 1 is A. So, A plus 0 is A, A into 1 is A. This is, it implies 0 and identity elements for operations plus and negative respectively. Here, this is the addition operation. Here, it is a multiplication action. That is, A plus 0 is equal to A, A into 1 is A. This is for addition and multiplication. Further, there is no element E in R with A minus E equals E minus A belonging to A. We cannot find any element E in R star such that A divided by E and E divided by A for all values of A in R. Hence, subtraction and division do not have identity elements. Note, let us note. 0 is identity for addition. See, 0 is the identity for addition and 1 is the identity for multiplication. So, note, 0 is identity for addition operation on R, but it is not identity for addition operation on N, as 0 is not belonging to N. 0 is not there in N. In fact, the addition operation on N does not have any identity. You please note, there may be a one mark question on this. Number two, one further notices that for addition operation plus R cross R from R cross R to R given by A belonging to R, there exists minus A in R such that A plus of within brackets minus A is equal to 0. That is A minus A equals 0. That is identity for plus. Definition number 4. Given a binary operation star equals from A cross A to A with the identity element E in A, an element A belonging to A is said to be invertible with respect to operation star if there exists an element B in A such that A star B is equal to E, that is equal to B star A, and B is called inverse. Inverse of A, and it is denoted by A to the power of minus 1 or A bar. Sometimes we write A bar also. Question number 13. Show that minus A is the inverse of A for addition operation plus on R and 1 by A is the inverse of A not equal to 0. So here if A becomes 0, it becomes not defined. Except for 0, it is inverse for multiplication operation X on R. Answer. A plus of within brackets minus A is equal to A minus A is equal to 0. Therefore, minus of A plus A is also equal to 0. So, minus A is the inverse of A for addition. Similarly, for A not equal to 0, A cross 1 over A equals 1. It implies that 1 by A is the inverse of A. So, for addition, minus A is the inverse of A, and for multiplication, 1 by A is the inverse of A. Question number 14. Show that minus A is not the inverse of A belonging to N for addition operation plus on N, and 1 over A is not an inverse of A belonging to N for multiplication operation cross on N for A not equal to 1. Since minus A is not belonging to N, minus A cannot be inverse of A for addition operation on N. N is an whole integer except 0. That is, N is 1, 2, 3, all positive numbers. So there is no negative minus A on in the N set N. Although minus A satisfied, A minus A is equal to 0. That is equal to minus of A plus A. Similarly, for A not equal to 1 in N, comma 1 over A not belonging to N, which implies that other than 1, no element of N has inverse for multiplication operation on N. Therefore, if A is equal to 1, then only it satisfies the multiplication operation. Note, addition on R is commutative and associative binary operation with 0 as identity element and minus A as the inverse of A in R for all values of A. Question number 15. Determine whether or not each of definition of star given below gives a binary operation. In the event that star is not a binary operation, give justification for this. On Z, for all positive values of integer Z, define binary operation star by A star B is equal to A minus B. So here A binary B equals A minus B. Let us answer. A star B is equal to A minus B, that is given. Let us take for example A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 3. So therefore 1 minus 3 is minus 2, which is not belonging to Z plus, because Z plus has only positive values. Hence A minus B is not a binary on Z plus. Case 2. On Z plus, define binary operation by A star B is equal to AB. Here A star B is AB. This is multiplication. Answer. A star B is equal to AB. It is given. That is, let us take A as 3 and B is equal to 7. Some arbitrary number you can assign. 3 into 7, that is equal to 21, which belongs to Z positive. Hence, AB is a binary operation on Z plus. Case 3. On R define binary star by A star B is equal to AB square. Here A operation binary B, A star B is given by AB square. Therefore A star b is equal to ab square given. Let us assume a is equal to 2 and b is equal to 3. Therefore, 2 into 3 square is equal to 18, which belongs to R. Hence, AB square is a binary operation on R. Case number 4. On Z plus, define binary star by A star B is equal to absolute A minus B. Therefore, A star B is equal to absolute A minus B. That is, 1. Let us assume A is 1 and B is equal to 4. 1 minus 4. That is equal to minus 3. And mod of minus 3 is always positive. That is 3. Belonging to Z plus. So, hence, absolute A minus B is a binary operation on Z plus. All these equations, you have to assume certain value of A as well as B. And you prove that there exists it number in Z positive. Z positive is all positive integers. Fifth question. On Z plus, define binary, that is asterisk or star, by A star B is equal to A. Here A, B is equal to A. Therefore, answer is A star B is equal to A. That is equal to A. That belongs to Z plus. Hence, A is a binary operation on Z plus. Next question. Question number 16. For each operation, binary operation, star, defined below, determine whether star is binary, commutative or associative. First, I will correct myself. We have to read question as, for each operation, star, defined below, determine whether star is binary. Here we have to determine whether star is binary, commutative or associative. On Z, define A star B equals A minus B. So, A star B is equal to B star A. That is, A minus B equals A minus B, which is minus of minus AB. Hence, it becomes negative and it is not belonging to Z. Hence, not commutative. Next case. A star B within brackets star C. Therefore, A star B star C within bracket. Therefore, if we take subtraction A minus B, that is A minus B minus C is equal to A minus of B minus C. So, which is not same. Hence, A minus B minus C is not equal to A minus B plus C. Hence, it is not associative. Case number 2. On Q, define A star B is equal to AB plus 1. Here, the given operation is AB plus A. 1. Sorry. A star B is equal to B star A. We know the commutative property is A star B is equal to B star A. That is, here the A star B is given as AB plus 1. That is, it should be equal to 1 plus AB. Hence, AB plus 1 is commutative. That is, left hand side is equal to right hand side. Then next is associative. A star B within brackets star C is equal to A of star B star C. Therefore, AB plus 1, that is A star B is given as AB plus 1 into C equals A into BC plus 1. Hence, ABC is not equal to ABC plus 1. Therefore, ABC plus C is not equal to ABC plus A. Hence, it is not associative. Number 3. On Q, define A star B equals AB by 2. Here, A star B equals B star A. Therefore, A star B is AB by 2 and BA by 2 on the right hand side. Hence, AB by 2 is equal to BA by 2. Hence, AB is commutative. Therefore, now associative. This is commutative variety, associative. A star B star C is equal to A star of B star C. Therefore, A is AB by 2 star C divided by 2 is equal to A star BC by 2. Whole thing divided by 2. 2, 2 gets cancelled and what remains is AB by 2. Hence AB by 2 is associated.